birth 4/27/98. Today's date 4/23/02. Okay. You ready, Jared?
Get that.
Oh, for goodness sake. There you go.
There were problems that they had to give a shot to his mom so that she wouldn't have the baby any earlier than it was she was supposed to. And even with that, then he was still born early. His local doctor that at that time was in Northfield, and we lived near Faribault in a town called Warsaw at that time. Probably a few months old when we realized that he wasn't acting the same way as other kids did. And mostly that was the physical. His legs weren't moving the way we thought they should have. We had an orthopedic doctor for his bones and a gait doctor for his walking. And they'd take pictures of him and take pictures of the way he walked and decide what to do next and how to best proceed with his walking.
Reach up, reach up high, reach up high, reach up high, reach up high. Go, 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 buddy. Go, 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 go.
Nice job.
Yay, buddy.
Yay.
They had to explain it, I know that, and really cerebral palsy is a lack of oxygen at the time of birth. And that lack of oxygen can affect any part of your brain. And so cerebral palsy can have various types depending on what part of your body is affected or how much.
I have spastic quadriplegia, which is a form where it only affects one side of your body mostly, and for me it affects my left side because I don't get quite as much like range of motion or abilities in my left side.
His cerebral palsy is actually very minimal compared to many people. You know, many people are wheelchair bound the rest of their life, and some of them, well, you can't even tell they have cerebral palsy too.
Cowlick thing. Yeah, it doesn't like to work very well some days.
But Jared's affected his legs. More than anything, his legs.
You got it?
Once we got going and got rid of that walk, because now the only time, I'm sure you see him all the time with his walker. That's the only time he uses his walkers at school. The only time, you know.
Thank you.
chapitre 2, toi,
côté de chez lui, on a décidé que le...
I met Jared back in 2014, the start of sophomore year. I had first hour with him, and my first impression of him was that I didn't even know that he had a disability. Yeah, I just thought he was just another student. Because I arrived late to class, so I sat behind him, and the teacher was going off doing with the syllabus, and I just met him, and I didn't notice anything much about him.
Did you see his walker?
No, I did not see his walker.
With Jared, I think so many kids and teachers don't know who he is, don't know like truly who he is, because of the walker and because of the disability.
Do you think these people look at you differently because you have the walker?
Yeah, I think if I didn't have it, they'd look at me more as a normal person, let's say, and then so they wouldn't make prejudgments on certain abilities that I can do.
When he was here, there was a big discussion about should Jared be using his walker all the time, because he was able to walk without it, but it was, I think his dad wanted him to try coming to school without the walker, and so I think his dad really, and in my opinion, was like, this would be a great chance for you to kind of show these kids what you can do without it. And so the goal was to get him walking without the walker at school.
Hi, Jared.
Okay.
See you, buddy.
See ya. Jared, when are you going to be in the movie?
What do you think about Jared going to school without his walker?
I think he would be fine. We do it all the time for walks, doctor appointments, right?
Yeah, the biggest thing is I might have to stay like a little, I might have to watch it a little closer just because there's a lot of people.
Probably leave class early.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd have to do that for sure. Yeah. Because sometimes the kids are good and other times not so much. So kind of have to, oh.
But I think he'll do fine.
Yeah, that's what I think too.
Yeah.
It'd be weird.
I know it will.
Yeah, basically it's become second nature, and if I don't have it, I think I'm missing something.
When he was about 3 or 4, the therapist that was working with him, she said he walked a couple feet, you know, without any help. And I was kind of overjoyed, but it didn't really seem to catch on.
When was the last time you used it?
Last summer.
I was just concentrating, what can I do to strengthen his legs? What can I do to strengthen him in those legs so that he can walk, so that he will walk? And I went out and got a bike.
Like anyone, he's got challenges that he has to face. I think his challenges are much harder than most, but I mean, I think we could all learn from Jared to be happy and have a great attitude and try hard at everything. And I think you could take Jared and give him some other challenge, you know, so if he didn't have his physical disability, you could give him a different challenge and he would overcome that.
now you're just walking down the hallway. That's the way it feels to walk down the hallway.
Like if I had a son that didn't have cerebral palsy. But then again, Jared wouldn't be the same kid. I realized that long ago, that he wouldn't have the same attitude. If everything else was equal, he wouldn't have the same attitude. He wouldn't have the same smile. He wouldn't have the same ability to touch people. And so I thank the Lord for his cerebral palsy. And not just for him, but for me.
I appreciate how much I am able to do, even if it'd be nice to do more, but I gotta think of it as I gotta take advantage of what I can do instead of what I can't at this point.
I think it was inspiring just to see. It sounds strange, but it's inspiring to see what just a normal life he was leading, given all the things that were in his way, and all the kids that aren't able to lead a normal life that don't have any challenges.
Living in the